Anastasia, your host for Coffee Chat with Anastasia. We are here at the Greater New York meeting. I've got a friend and colleague, Emily Bogie. We're going to do a coffee clink. Clink. She designed a new instrument. Tell us about this instrument. I'm going to hold your coffee.
Okay.
Walk us through where we would use this and how important that's going to make a difference in hygienists, the way that they practice, and in our patients' health.
It is a hoe. It's a modified hoe though. The terminal shank is a little bit longer. It's slightly wider. Sometimes when people see this instrument, they say, oh my gosh, that's kind of wide. Well, the reason it's wide is because that width provides dimensional stability, so you don't roll off the tooth. So you're going to use this instrument primarily when you're cleaning these lower anterior teeth, especially if people have those fixed retainers that you can never get down and around.
Oh, yes.
Or for your elderly patients that have a whole bunch of recession with some abfraction, some notching along the cervical margins.
What about the people who have tongue piercings? I see a lot of recession in the mandibular linguals. That's really tough because it collects so much tartar. Uh-huh. It collects a lot of stain. And you know what? I don't care who you are, even if you use an ultrasonic tip, sometimes we seem to gouge, but we don't mean to.
Mm-hmm.
So this lifts it away.
Yeah, and these XP instruments really grab a hold of stain, and they grab a hold of that real fine tartar that sometimes you can't get a hold of with a regular stainless steel instrument. I wanted the inside edge of the instrument to have the sharp cutting edge. The outside of the instrument is smooth, but the inside has the cutting edge. So you can even bring it back here to the distal of the second molar and really work on this area without worrying about damaging the tissue that's along the cervical margin.
I'll tell you what, when you're talking about the edge, that would be a bear to sharpen. And with XP, you don't have to.
No, you don't need to worry about that. In the office, it would be very difficult, if not impossible, to sharpen this instrument, because it really was designed to be sharpened at the manufacturer, used for its entire life, and then discarded and get another one. That's what XP will allow you to do. Because you can be so feather light with your strokes, you don't have to feel like you're cranking.
Yeah.
It goes a long way for ergonomics. I'm the program administrator at school, and I'm always telling the students, you know, you have to take care of yourself, because if you don't take care of yourself, you can't take care of your patient. People can understand that it's gonna start sharp and stay consistent. I think consistency is key. Every time you pick up an XP instrument, it's got the same cutting edge, it's got the same shape, you're not whittling it down.
Right.
So you know what you're putting in the mouth every time. And the really cool thing about this is when I designed it, I thought lower anterior, I thought around orthobrackets, and now I'm having a hygienist yesterday come out to me and said, you know, facial of number 3, how a lot of people get that heavy stain, you know, being right by the parotid gland there, gets a marginal tartar.
Yes.
She said that thing just gets right in there.
You've got the other end of it. So tell us what the other end is, because...
Okay, so this is a double-ended instrument. In addition to the hoe end, the modified hoe end, that the cutting edge is again on the inside, we have this very skinny, tiniest little sickle, and it's called a Nebraska 128. And the coolest thing about this tiny little sickle is, since it's made in XP and you're never planning on sharpening it, it comes to you really skinny.
We always recognize hoes to be used with people who've got massive amount of calculus or tartar, like a bridge and stuff. If they've got recession, the stain, even if it's light, you use the hoe end.
Right.
But then, like, maybe just to fine tune it, you could use the sickle end.
Right, exactly right. I always like when people have that overlapped, crowded,
yes.
You know, those orthodontic wires do a great job, but they don't always keep things perfectly straight. So you get a little rotation here and there. Even with overlapping, man, this thing is so skinny. It can
fit
through a crack in the wall, man. It's an awesome instrument in itself, but paired with this hoe, you're strolling along here, getting all that tartar and the fine stain off there. Then you flip it over. Come back with the same instrument.
Because not everybody's teeth are that straight, so I mean, that makes total sense.
But the maxillary, people that have that recession on the roof of the mouth, facial and lingual, you're not flipping back and forth your tray, you're working in the same area, same instrument.
This you're actually introducing into a hygiene class. How cool is that?
Yeah, so next year, my senior students and their specialty instrument kits are going to have XP. And I'm really excited about it because at Hawkeye College, we really want our students to graduate and have a long, successful career.
I want to thank you for your time and thank American Eagle actually for taking, you know, understanding the needs of the dental hygienist, understanding the career limitations of the dental hygienist, and then also grasping the effect of how effective an instrument can be. Thank you for joining us. Congratulations on making this international and national in the United States. I'm just honored to know somebody that gets what's going on. So cheers to you. Till next time, take what you learn and make a difference with it.